Heritage. Thanks for watching.
This is a WTOC original presentation.
It's time to move the flag from the Capitol grounds.
The removal of the Confederate battle flag from the South Carolina Capitol grounds has opened up a big can of worms. The question now, what other monuments are appropriate in the public square?
Sometimes you may even have to chip into the foundation to rebuild. I think that's where we are right now.
You need to free the future from the icy grip of the past.
Questionable decision by law enforcement led WTOC News to wonder what it's like to walk in a cop's shoes. We'll do that just ahead.
How long does it take for our brain to process the threat and react to that threat?
I'm leaving tomorrow, but and if you're leaving tonight.
What really happened in the Mercer House the night that Jim Williams shot Danny Hansford? John Barry, author of Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, has his own thoughts.
I didn't have actual physical proof. I just knew. And I have to say, a lot of Jim's friends just knew.
All ahead on WTOC Prime. When pictures of accused murderer Dylan Roof emerged, brandishing the Confederate battle flag, it signaled a tipping point for South Carolina's elected leadership when they were finally able to put the flag issue behind them after more than a decade of uneasiness. But the flag has brought into question other monuments in the public square. What, if anything, should be done about those? When the Confederate battle flag was removed from the grounds of the South Carolina State Capitol, it was a relief to Alex Brown of Hilton Head Island.
What does the flag represent to you, the Confederate flag?
Well, to me personally, Mike, I'll be honest, the flag for a long time brought some fear more than anything else, you know, because growing up, you're taught what it stands for. You start to equivalent that with hate groups. So as a kid, I was always afraid when I saw the flag.
No fear for historian Stan Deaton, but he does believe that the flag's removal from public spaces is the beginning of the South asking itself a long smoldering question.
Is it any longer necessary for us to memorialize what many people to consider to have been the greatest internal threat the United States has ever faced? I think it's a legitimate discussion to have.
I think we're at a point now where we're moving forward, okay? You've got to tear down some walls every once in a while to rebuild, and sometimes you may even have to chip into the foundation to rebuild. I think that's where we are right now.
The debate is shifting now to a broader conversation that looks both deep into the past and far into the future. In Atlanta, the NAACP wants Stone Mountain cleansed of Stonewall Jackson, Robert E. Lee, and Jefferson Davis. Deaton notes that the symbols of the Confederacy are unique in the land.
There is a long tradition in this country for doing this. After the American Revolution, things with royal names disappeared. There's a reason there's not a King and Queen Street in Savannah, but there is a President and a State Street. Statues of King George III came down all across this country. Why? Because Americans wanted to decide who they wanted to honor. They didn't think those names represented their values anymore. And I think that's a legitimate thing. I think it's something that has gone on always in this country. There's also something to be said for letting statues stay up and the people that they represent slip from our public memory. We don't even know who they are anymore.
Deaton doesn't support removing monuments to Confederate war heroes, nor does Brown. But
are there other symbols that you feel need to come down? Or this is a huge first step, let's move forward?
Yes, to the last part, in terms of this being a huge step forward. The monuments, at least in my mind, you don't see people equivalent the monuments with hatred. You know, you got these hate groups that make videos. This is a way of them recruiting members. So the flag, at least in my mind, stands for a whole lot more than a monument, okay? Do we need to go back and make sure we hash out and teach the exact history when it comes to these monuments? Well, I think so.
To get to the point about their cast people in a favorable light, the statue for Dr. King in Washington, D.C., any statue of Dr. King is not going to have anything on there about the allegations of plagiarism or adultery that we know about from having studied his life. The statue to Thomas Jefferson in Washington doesn't say anything about Sally Hemings or the fact that he owned slaves. He's an apostle of liberty. That is the way that we choose to remember him, but that's an incomplete picture.
Joe Dawson has a dog in this fight, too. Dawson is a member of the Francis Bartow chapter of the Sons of Confederate Veterans. Dawson says monuments like this one to Bartow hold an important place in the history of the South.
Francis Bartow, in his day, was a man among men. You have to understand, in 1860, your state was your country. And he went to defend his state from invasion. Just like the rest of the Confederate soldiers did, they fought the most valiant fight known to man, and that was to defend their homes and families from an illegal and unconstitutional invasion of the South.
The Sons of Confederate Veterans do not concede that the Civil War was fought over slavery. They believe that money and the inherent tension between the industrial North and agricultural South were the true culprits.
You know, the flag came down, but what are we going to put up? You know, what story are we going to tell the next generation?
Just ahead, we conclude our monumental discussion with some suggestions to solve the dilemma. And later, we ask the question that Midnight carefully skirted.
Did Jim ever tell you that's what happened?
Not in so many words.
Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on Ford Focus with EcoBoost.
EcoBoost with super fat.
Ford is the brand more people buy and buy again. So don't miss the Ford Summer Sales Event. Now during the Summer Sales Event, get a Focus with 0 for 72 plus $1,000 and no payments for 90 days. Only at your local Ford dealer.
Escape the fast food merry-go-round, Seasons of Japan.
Welcome to Seasons of Japan. Have you signed up for our Seasons of Japan points?
You can now sign up for Seasons of Japan reward points. Every dollar you spend earns you points towards a free meal.
I've already got my points.
Enjoy Seasons of Japan in South Carolina, Georgia, Florida, Illinois, and California. And now open our newest location on Victory Drive in Savannah. Come see us today.
IDS Specialty Building Products is proud to offer a full line of beautiful kitchen and bath cabinetry. We offer unmatched variety, customer service, expert guidance, and excellent pricing while following a standardized sales and installation process. IDS designers have countless years experience, so you can trust us to offer professional advice to help you make the right choices. IDS Specialty. Check us out online, on Facebook, or in person. We are right around the corner in Bloomingdale, minutes away from Pooler, I-95, and I-16.
Dr. Stan Deaton rightly points out that monuments are not history, they are public art placed to honor, perhaps even to glorify a figure. But they are hardly a complete picture, and that's the problem we face when a community's sensibilities change. Stan Deaton was out in front of a move a couple of years ago to rename the Talmadge Bridge, an effort that ultimately failed, at least for now.
A lot of people in Savannah are uncomfortable with Eugene Talmadge's name on our bridge. Now, obviously, we're not going to take the bridge down. Taking one name off and putting another on is like repurposing a building. McDonald's moves out and Gap moves in. That bridge is going to be there. I think the question this community has asked and will ask again is Eugene Talmadge represent who we are as Georgians in 2015 as one of the most racist, demagogue governors who ever ruled? Do his values still represent who we are? We're not going to tear the bridge down because his name is on it, but we might put someone else's name on there, or we might not. But I don't think there's anything sacrosanct about that name or his, anybody else's name, being on a building or on a structure that is going to remain even if the name is taken off. That, to me, is different than taking a monument or a statue down.
But in Atlanta, there used to be a statue of turn-of-the-century politician Tom Watson on the Capitol grounds. That monument has been moved to a park, ostensibly for renovations, but Deaton notes that Watson is not a hero, as we understand the word today.
Is an incomplete picture of Tom Watson. He said he made his reputation in part because of things he said about Jews and African Americans that we would consider, and many people in his own day considered, to be vile statements. But his popularity with poor rural Georgians in part rested upon those things. It's not on the monument, but I think we could place something next to it that contextualized that rather than tear it down.
Alex Brown isn't in favor of removing any monuments, but he does insist on a more complete presentation of the story of the people that are memorialized.
You don't want our next generation to be oblivious to the fact of how these things came about, okay? And not just tell some of the story when it comes to history, but tell the entire story.
One island, one community, one Hilton Head.
Brown teamed with Hilton Head Island Mayor David Bennett earlier this year to create a movement to unify the people of the Lowcountry under the One Hilton Head banner.
So let's focus a little more on, again, the new monuments, you know, what we're going to be standing for moving forward. You know, the flag came down, but what are we going to put up? You know, what story are we going to tell the next generation in terms of them coming together and loving one another? That's more important to me.
Deaton agrees that this mess may solve itself.
We're already seeing, I think this means less to younger people than it does to older people, and that's natural. I think as time goes on, there may come a day 50 years from now, 100 years from now, where the idea that we still need to define ourselves with an attachment to the Confederacy may be gone.
Up later, David Clue finds out what it's like to be a cop in a sticky situation.
Put your hands above your head. There's an alarm going.
But just ahead, Dawn Baker has the story of a local woman proud that she's descended from slaves.
I thank God that his blood is in my veins.
The WTOC Sports Desk is sponsored by Franklin Toyota in Statesboro. Huge selection and incredible value. You'll find it at Franklin in Statesboro or franklintoyota.com.
If you've been injured on the job, the interruption of regular paychecks can be devastating to your family. Don't rely on the insurance company or your employer to be looking out for your best interests. At the Eichos Law Firm, we built thejusticelawyer.com so you can spend all the time you need having your questions answered or have a live chat 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Your family is counting on you, and you can count on us. Call us at 1-800-JUSTICE, the Eichos Law Firm, the Justice Lawyer.
You paid too much for those glasses.
Who?
You. Designer frames? Well, so are these. And these. And these. And they all cost less than those.
How?
America's Best, where two pairs of designer glasses and a free eye exam start at $69.95. Get ready to...
turn some heads.
Save money.
That's good, too.
The designer sales event is not just a better deal. It's America's Best. Hurry, sale ends soon.
Patients from the Coastal Empire and Lowcountry choose St. Joseph's Candler Immediate Care when they need quality, urgent medical care.
My family's experience at Immediate Care has been amazing. Not only do I come here, but I also bring my daughter here. They get us back very quickly. There's no long wait, and they make sure we have the absolute best care.
St. Joseph's Candler Immediate Care has 5 convenient locations, open 7 days a week with no appointment necessary. St. Joseph's Candler Immediate Care, the right choice for urgent care.
Stay safe with the WTOC First Alert Weather Tips. No place is safe outside during a thunderstorm. If you hear thunder, lightning is close enough to strike you. Stay safe and get inside.
Sponsored by Vaden Nissan of Statesboro.
Slavery is in the blood of America. And while that may be a shameful part of the country's past, that shame doesn't touch the people who were victims, the people who were enslaved. At least it doesn't for Estelle Mannion. Estelle Mannion shows off pictures of her family that date back to the early 1900s. But there are no pictures of the two she's most proud of today, her great-grandparents, Anderson and Tara White. We know they once lived here in Jasper County, South Carolina, in Cherry Hill. There is, however, a paper trail that documents their bravery and perseverance. Anderson White was a slave.
Sometimes it moves me almost to tears to see that I am here free and have such liberties now, and my grandfather was one who helped to pay the price for my freedom. It's overwhelming. It is, wow. This we read about.
Anderson White lived in Charleston and had to walk to Ridgeland more than 70 miles to become a soldier and fight for our country.
For a long time, blacks weren't allowed to fight in the Civil War until they thought they were losing. So I think he was a brave, brave soldier to have left a wife and three kids to go to fight for his country. Back then, blacks were considered almost less than livestock. But yet, he went and he served this country.
White was buried here in Boland Hall in Ridgeland. His widow, Tara, had to fight the government for six long years before she got his small pension. Now, these are the papers the family found not long ago, archived at the Department of Interior in Washington, D.C., that document her fight to prove she and Anderson were actually married, and therefore she deserved the money.
She was denied that $12 a month. And that $12 a month meant a lot. That fed them, that clothed them. It could not have been easy. She was a woman who persevered and who just didn't give up.
Hundreds of years later, Anderson and Tara's struggle remain a source of pride and motivation for this family and generations to come.
I can't imagine how hard it must have been. But I thank God that his blood is in my veins. It makes us survivors, people who are the best of the best of the best of the best, to have survived slavery, survived a war, to survive the hard times. It just makes me feel so, so proud, you know, that he gave something back to this country. So it makes me feel like, okay, Estelle, you gotta do more.
Estelle Mannion runs a successful advertising agency in Savannah.
Just put this beach here, put 10 feet of storm surge on the beach. The water's going way inland.
Up next, will you go if a hurricane bears down on the coast? The misery of Hurricane Floyd's evacuation has some worry that the public may not run from the water, even if they should. And later, the first ever Meta book draws a huge crowd to downtown Savannah for the premiere. That's ahead.
Sayuri 516 posted,
off to buy stuff for the home, stuff for the kids, even stuff for the dog. Hashtag bigger Honda, please.
Wow, looks like it's time to switch your Accord for a CRV. Oh, I mean an Odyssey. Come to the Honda Summer Clearance Event. The Odyssey is the best-selling minivan in its class with plenty of room for all of them.
I love it.
Actually, there's room for more.
Hurry in to the Honda Summer Clearance Event for a great deal on your new Honda.
Freight notice this weekend at American Freight. Over 1,000 truckloads of living room furniture. Seven-piece living room groups that include a sofa, love seat, coffee table, two end tables, and two designer lamps. You get all seven pieces from only $398 complete. Free layaway, same-day delivery. Come to the loading docks this weekend only at American Freight in Savannah at 15,000 Abercorn Street. Look for the big American flag. 232-2229.
The most live sports like never before. With the sports app on X1 from Xfinity, you can track live scores and easily switch between closed games.
Oh, I love that. It's all on one screen. I'm a fan.
Anywhere that you have Wi-Fi, you can stream live SEC games on any device.
So I can stream three different games at the same time and catch the scores on every single one.
That's kind of cool.
Get exclusive SEC football games you can only get on the SEC Network. Upgrade to the Xfinity X1 Triple Play with the SEC Network included. Call 1-800-XFINITY or go online to
Dental practice, we're giving you a whole new reason to smile. We're not just your average dentist, we're so much more. We specialize in comprehensive, preventive, restorative, and cosmetic care, as well as implant dentistry. Over 80 years of combined experience means we have the tools to address any need, including IV sedation, laser dentistry, sleep disorders, and treatment of TMJ, to name a few. With 3 locations to serve you, call today.
Will you go? If a hurricane threatens the coast, will you evacuate? There's some concern that people who experienced the nightmare of Hurricane Floyd exodus may not leave. Our discussion begins on Hilton Head Island.
So, Tom, 48 hours before evacuation, and the biggest problem? That.
Just put this beach here, put 10 feet of storm surge on the beach. The water's going way inland. Storm surge is the key. Water is the key.
Tom Dunn is the emergency management coordinator for the town of Hilton Head Island.
About 35, 36,000 people.
Just kind of looking at the landscape right here, there is no shelter. There's nowhere to go. I mean...
Correct. We're the low country for a reason, because we're low.
People living on Hilton Head have several issues to tackle when a hurricane threatens. One is the evacuation nightmare of the single road, Highway 278, that connects the island to the mainland.
It's pretty obvious we have one way in and one way out off the island, so that creates a bottleneck. So that's the importance of people planning and preparing and leaving early.
To navigate the bottleneck, emergency management has devised a plan to distribute the traffic.
If you're leaving Hilton Head, obviously you have one way on, one way off. So you're going 278 all the way out to either 170, you'll go to 17 or 95,
okay,
depending on which lane you're in. And I think that's an important point. If you wait till a mandatory evacuation, you are put in a lane, and wherever that lane goes is where you go. So you don't get to choose where you go. So if you leave before, you get to choose where you go. If you wait, you don't get to choose.
Unlike Chatham County, which may evacuate only certain areas, all of Beaufort County will evacuate when the order is issued, and the order is mandatory.
The decision on whether to evacuate takes on added complications for the islands around Savannah. A major thoroughfare for Wilmington, Tybee, Whitmarsh, and Tulagi is President Street, and it's currently undergoing a major overhaul.
So this is a canal right here. It's the Bilbo Canal. And basically, all water from downtown ends up there.
There are actually two projects going on simultaneously on President Street. One is the widening and deepening of the Bilbo Canal to accommodate the water flowing and flooding downtown Savannah.
It'll be like 5 times as wide as it is right now, and deeper as well. So this is important because it's the very end of the line for this massive Bilbo drainage system.
The canal is 19th century infrastructure, no longer capable of handling 21st century population growth.
Yeah, this is where it all goes to.
But city engineers believe the real solution to President Street chronic flooding lies with dramatically changing the road itself.
The bigger solution for flooding, chronic flooding on our major hurricane evacuation route is just raising the elevation about 6 feet.
The project will take 2 years and span 2 hurricane seasons, and the biggest impact comes next year.
We have a massive lane shift, so the roadway that we see right now will be about 20 or 30 feet over here to the south. The lanes will become narrower, and they'll jog, and they'll be uneven. So traffic will be much slower, it'll be more compacted, it'll feel tighter, it'll be a bigger impact.
Fixing President Street has been talked about for over 30 years. Now that it's happening, people are concerned about disruptions and traffic snarls. But Bell says the time spent will pay off by freeing President Street from the grip of the Bilbo Canal, which operates on a system of metal gates that are hounded by problems.
Now is a good time to download the WTOC weather app and make sure you're on top of hurricane progress and the traffic issues that go along with it.
It's a wonderful night in Harbor Town.
Just ahead, we'll take you to the most celebrated oak tree in the Lowcountry. It's center stage these days, and we'll feel what the police feel when they read a call.
How does the general public do?
Awful. Japan.
Hi, welcome to Seasons of Japan. Have you signed up for our Seasons of Japan points?
You can now sign up for Seasons of Japan reward points. Every dollar you spend earns you points towards a free meal.
I've already got my points.
Enjoy Seasons of Japan in South Carolina, Georgia, Florida, Illinois, and California. And now open our newest location on Victory Drive in Savannah. Come see us today.
It's the final week of Ashley Furniture Home Store's National Sale and Clearance Event, a $500 million inventory blowout. Save up to 70% on select items store-wide. Get incredibly low prices on sofas, dining rooms, recliners, and queen beds, all starting at just $299. Plus, get no interest for 3 years. Also, save up to $1,000 on Sealy Posturepedic and Simmons Beauty Rest Pillow Top Mattresses. Hurry in. Ashley Furniture Home Store. This is home. Shop now at AshleyFurnitureHomeStore.com.
What do you say? We'll get right on.
Never underestimate what people can accomplish, especially young people. Most of us would have been skeptical if someone had tried to put special needs children together with surfing. But guess what? Or better yet, watch.
These are not your typical Hilton Head teenager surfer dudes, at least not on this day. On this day, these teens are sharing their love of the beach and the ocean and surfing with others.
Surfing's something I love to do, and I figured they'd love it too.
James Bartholomew recruited his pals to share a summer afternoon with kids who don't normally get a chance to test their skills on the wave.
And it brings our community together, and all the kids hang out together, and it's not just special needs kids, but also typical kids that join us too.
James' inspiration came from his sister, Sally.
Well, my sister has special needs, and she always loves coming and watching me surf.
Check.
Christopher McPherson.
Hi. Christina. Sydney.
Darcy. Echo Double.
So James figured if Sally liked it, others might too. And they don't just like it. They got pretty good at it while feeling like they were part of what was happening on Hilton Head Island.
It's important for our community to understand that there's a group of people that wants to be part of our community and wants to play and be with us and play.
That was the first time Hilton Head surfers got that group together. But there are plans to make it an ongoing event, maybe even all summer long. Thanks for watching WTOC Prime. When we come back, we'll take you to Harbortown, where the temperature is dropping and the breeze is coming off the Calabogie Sound. Stay right there.
I broke my hip in a terrible car accident. It took 2 years to get my settlement, and I only got $25,000. Man, I should have called Ken.
When I hurt my back in a car wreck, I called Ken. One call, and he got me $300,000. Yeah, you should have called Ken.
Now, I can't guarantee you that kind of money, but if you've been hurt in a car wreck, you should call me. One call, that's all.
You don't even have to leave your house. We'll come to you. Call 1-800-CALL-KEN. That's 1-800-CALL-KEN.
While enjoying the outdoors, protect yourself from skin cancer.
Choose cosmetics and contact lenses that offer UV protection while also using sunscreen and wearing sunglasses.
Dr. Susan Holland always says, don't forget to play safe in the sun.
Everybody talks, it started with the whisper.
People just can't stop talking about Ford. Announcing the Ford Summer Sales Event. Now get our best offers of the year on Focus, Fusion, and Escape. 0% financing for 72 months, plus $1,000 cash back, and no payments until fall. That's 0 for 72, plus $1,000 cash back, and no payments until fall on Focus, Fusion, and Escape during the Ford Summer Sales Event at your local Ford dealer.
Injured? Call Owens and Mulherin.
A big insurance company can grind out 35,000 claims a day.
To them, your car accident is just business, but to you, it's personal.
And what's personal to you matters to us. At Owens and Mulherin, we've served the people of Savannah for over 20 years.
Let our experience work for you.
If you've been injured in a car accident, call Owens and Mulherin, 212-2100.
You want to feel connected, informed, included on every screen in your life. We are broadcasters, always here for you, wherever here may be. Text Washington. Tell them local stations matter.
Greg Russell wrote the soundtrack for Hilton Head Island, played annually by CBS as part of their coverage of the RBC heritage. One of its phrases says, "There's nowhere I'd rather be than under these stars and this old tree." The old tree is known as the Liberty Oak, now enjoying its moment in the sun.
Say hi-oh!
This is the most celebrated oak on Hilton Head, the Liberty Oak, made famous by Greg Russell's 39 years of performances and as the final resting place for Charles Frazier. Frazier was a Hinesville boy whose family was in the timber business, which led them to Hilton Head and the founding of Sea Pines. But Frazier wasn't just a businessman. He was also an environmentalist who fought hard to safeguard the natural beauty of Hilton Head, especially the live oaks scattered around Sea Pines.
He designated this Six Oaks as a park in Sea Pines, a 24-acre park. He also protected the signature oak of Sea Pines, which is the Liberty Oak in Harbortown, which was in the middle of his harbor that he wanted to build. So if you look at the harbor, you'll see this protrusion coming out into this circular space, and he insisted on keeping that that tree.
John Parsons is a landscape architect who retired to Sea Pines in 2008. He was drawn to the Oaks and set about to establish the Legacy Oaks program.
Throughout the entire area of Sea Pines, on our leisure trails so that people on a bike could tour them, it takes about 3.5 hours to tour all of the trees, mm-hmm. if you want to do it in one gulp.
For more information on the project, go to seapineslegacyoak.org.
Here's an idea. Go tour the Legacy Oaks, then finish the afternoon with Greg Russell in Harbortown. Any night except Saturday, the rest of August. Just ahead, a look at the thought process of a police officer.
Anytime there's a pause or hesitation, it's going to cost you your life or somebody else's life.
And later, John Barrett.
They say, you know, the people here are not influenced by outside forces. I mean, they're not even aware of the outside world here.
Miss the Hot Tub and Swim Spa Blowout Expo this weekend at the Savannah Convention Center. Browse a huge display of hot tub swim spas and outdoor kitchens from major brands at up to 50% off. That's the Hot Tub and Swim Spa Blowout Expo this weekend at the Savannah Convention Center. Visit SpaExpo.com.
These trucks carry big insurance. So if you get hurt by one of these monsters, you're going to have a big case. But the trucking companies aren't just going to hand you the money without a fight. That's why you need to call me. I've handled hundreds of trucking cases, and sometimes my clients have been paid millions of dollars. Now, I can't guarantee you millions of dollars on your case, but if you've been hurt by a big truck, call me. I'm at the top of my game. One call, that's all.
Call 1-800-CALL-KEN.
Attention homeowners. Taking a bath in your high wall tub is an accident waiting to happen. But now, you can turn your existing tub or shower into a safe, easy-entry tub in just one day. With no tub walls to climb over, just open the door and walk right in. And the raised safety seat lets you bathe in comfort. Our easy-entry tubs are made in the USA with vital safety features, like a slip-resistant floor, ultra-low threshold, and watertight door with lifetime warranty. Now, you can enjoy the healing benefits of water therapy safely and easily.
I use it for everything. For bathing, for relaxing, and I don't have to worry.
So stop risking injury when you bathe. Our affordable, easy-entry tubs offer you the best safety value and service with factory-trained installation in just one day. For a limited time, save $1,500 and be one of the first 100 callers to get a free gift with purchase.
Call 1-800-205-0602. That's 1-800-205-0602.
Don't miss the Hot Tub and Swim Spa Blowout Expo this weekend at the Savannah Convention Center. Browse over 50 hot tubs and swim spas from five major brands at up to 50% off. Financing is available and show admission and parking are free. That's this weekend at the Savannah Convention Center. Visit SpaExpo.com.
It has not been a good year for the credibility of police officers across this country. Their decision-making has been questioned often and openly, from Ferguson, Missouri to Waller, Texas. In light of the increased public scrutiny, WTOC News went to the Georgia Public Safety Training Center to get a sense of an officer's perspective in the heat of the moment. It started in Ferguson, Missouri, where the actions of police officers triggered violence in the streets. It came to Augusta Avenue in Savannah when residents questioned the shooting of a fugitive arrested for outstanding warrants.
Get out of the car! And then you I will light you up! Get out!
Just this month, the actions of police officers in Waller, Texas, and the University of Cincinnati drew even more attention to police tactics.
We want to make the right decision. We don't want to shoot people that we don't want to use any force that's not necessary. Same scenario.
Major Harlan Prevost of the Georgia State Patrol and Metro Police Training Director Gary Taylor are responsible for making sure officers have the foundation they need to make the best decisions in the field.
Hello? Please.
To do that, they put officers in real-life scenarios to test their powers of observation and decision-making.
Ma'am, sir, sir.
In this situation, WTOC's Tim Williams answers a call to an area that's had several armed robberies. That's all Tim knows.
Stop! Police, stop! Stop! Sir, stop! Stop! Sir, let me see your hands! Sir, sir!
In spite of being ready, weapon aimed and steady, the suspect shot Tim first, an outcome that speaks to one of the principal dilemmas an officer faces.
How long does it take for our brain to process the threat and react to that threat?
Too long, I would assume, in the
we're always a trained officer.
Hour, a little better.
If he's got a gun behind here, it takes him 0.58 seconds. That's just over a half a second. 0.58 seconds to pull that gun, shoot, and turn around and run. It takes us almost a second and a half to process that
and react to it.
For our mind to perceive, okay, there's a deadly threat, now they react.
Hold it right there, sir. I'm a police officer.
On this call, I'm responding to a burglar alarm in a dark warehouse.
Both hands. Put your hands above your head. There's an alarm going.
What's clear in the video, but not clear in what I saw, was that the suspect had pulled out a staple gun from behind the box. In hindsight, my actions might have been wrong, but the law on such actions is not based on hindsight.
because your perception is the only perception that matters to the United States Supreme Court.
Right. Right.
What did you perceive to be the threat or not to be the threat? It's easy to second guess, and hindsight, you know, is always 20/20.
How easy is it to define the guidelines that every police officer must follow before using deadly force? Is it as simple as it was in the 60s?
It's as simple as you can define reasonableness.
Okay, so reasonable is the key.
Reasonableness is the key, and it's hard to define.
The controlling legal principle is the Supreme Court's decision in Graham versus Connor, which leans heavily on the perceived threat to an officer.
We'll never apologize for our survival skills that we teach in the police academy. Because if you look back from the 70s to now, the number of officers being killed is less and less. And we attribute that to officer survival skills. And we'll never apologize for teaching officer survival skills.
Get your hand out of your pocket. Both hands out of your pocket.
Hesitation or tentative decision-making can get you killed. Major Prevost cites the example of South Carolina trooper Mark Coates.
You know why he was killed?
No.
He had his hands in his pocket just like this, and when Mark Coates went to search him, he quickly pulled out a gun and shot the trooper from having his hands in his pocket. That's where he had his gun. Mm-hmm.
Get that light out of my eyes, man.
Many of the scenarios involve people screaming obscenities at the top of their lungs.
That's what they're going to face on the street.
Yeah.
So we'll just try to make it as realistic as possible.
If such language affects decision making, it's better that it be discovered at the training center than on the street. In spite of intense public scrutiny of the actions of the police officer, Taylor says that use of force is in fact a rare phenomenon.
2008, nationwide, there was 40 million contacts between law enforcement and the community, okay? Think about that now, 40 million instances of contact between law enforcement personnel and members of the community. During those 40 million contacts during 2008, 776,000 of those contacts, some type of force was used or threatened to be used. Comes out of what, 1.9%. The focus for us now is de-escalating these situations.
Right.
Of the hundreds of situations played out for police training, many do not involve the use of a weapon. That, say Taylor and Prevost, is because the first role of police is not force, and their best tool is not a pistol.
The most effective tool that they possess is their ability to speak and their ability to communicate and their ability to listen.
We want to thank the folks at Metro Police and the Georgia Training Center and Julian Miller, who, by the way, just retired from the police department. He's the one who gave us access to tell this story.
Pale moon shining on the fields below.
Up next, the characters who fueled midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil have yet another incarnation that's just ahead.
In a world that runs at the speed of information, when it comes to news, you don't need your time wasted. That's why you can turn to WTOC 11 News to bring you news live as it happens, to focus on local stories and how they impact you where you live, to get you the news you need now, no matter where you are. For the stories that stay with you, there's only WTOC 11 News, live, local, now.
After my accident, it took 3 years to get a settlement from the insurance company, and I still couldn't pay all my bills. I should have called Kent.
I was seriously injured when a semi-truck hit me and my sister. I knew what I needed to do. I called Kent first. Kent settled my case for $265,000. Yes, you should have called Kent.
Now, I can't guarantee you that kind of money, but if you've been hurt in a car wreck, you should call me. One call, that's all.
You don't even have to leave your house. We'll come to you. Call 1-800-CALL-KEN.
If you're under the age of 80, please watch this very important message about final expense insurance. While it's never easy to talk about planning for one's funeral, it is very important to do so for many reasons. If you don't have life insurance, a final expense insurance plan pays cash to your family for final and all other expenses. If you're unable to purchase life insurance due to a pre-existing or current medical condition, call us right now for information and a free consultation. Perhaps you can't afford life insurance because of your age or because you're a smoker. Call us now and we'll guarantee you coverage.
There are no tests to take and is very affordable. Rates will never increase, the policy cannot be canceled, and there are no restrictions on how your beneficiaries can use the money. Don't delay. Call right now.
Call 1-800-506-4396, 1-800-506-4396, 1-800-506-4396, 1-800-506-4396.
As storms move away, it looks like it'll be a better weekend for us. Your forecast tonight at 11.
21 years ago, a New York writer turned Savannah upside down by telling the world all of the hostess city's dirty little secrets. The city was at first aghast, but then as the tourist and tourism dollars poured in, we became gracious all over again. Now John Berendt has a new incarnation of Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, a meta book. And while he was in town promoting that, we took the opportunity to ask him the question that hadn't been asked before.
He came racing back in the room, crazed. Screaming out, his right arm was down by the side, and he said, "I'm leaving tomorrow, but God damn it, you're leaving tonight." And he took a pistol and pointed it dead at me. And if you never had that,
that's how Jim Williams portrayed his deadly encounter with Danny Hansford on May 2nd, 1981, a position that he maintained through four trials until he was finally acquitted.
But most people,
John Berendt, isn't so sure.
What do you think happened that night?
My own private opinion,
yes,
is that they got into an argument, and Jim shot Danny. That's what happened, I think. And I always did. And did I not say so? I did say so, but I didn't say so outright. I said so in a very subtle fashion. There are two places in the book where I make it very clear where I stand. When Jim dies of a heart attack at the end, I said he fell behind the desk in the very spot he would have fallen in if Danny Hansford had actually fired a gun and the shots had found their mark. The other time is Minerva saying, "Well, Mr. Jim lied to me. He lied to the court and he lied to me, and justice ain't been done yet." So the dead boy is working against him beyond the grave. I didn't come out and say he's guilty because, number one, he was found innocent. You have to respect that. And number two, I didn't have actual physical proof. I just knew. And I have to say a lot of Jim's friends just knew. And you can talk to them today. But he died right after being acquitted. What does that say?
Berendt is the author of Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil, the book that was the spark that lit Savannah's tourism fuse back in 1994. Midnight has sold more than 5 million copies worldwide. Perhaps more importantly, it was the rage of the literati and was featured in national media that reached tens of millions of eyes and ears. By the millions, those eyes and ears came to see what all the fuss was about in Savannah.
Pale moon shining on the fields below.
Berendt believes that was only fitting because the city herself was a main character.
How easy was it to make Savannah a character in the book? Which really is. It is. The city is a character.
Good question, because it was easy as pie. Savannah is a character. And a lot of reviewers caught on to that. And they said, there's this man, there's the guy who has the poison, there's the man who shot somebody. But many reviewers said, the main character of this book is Savannah. And that's right on. It is.
Can you appreciate the way that Savannah has changed in the years, not only since the book, but in a large part because of the book?
It all has to do with tourism, I guess. People reading the book, wanting to see the place where it all happened.
Right.
Having enjoyed the book, I suppose. And knowing that there's a magical city at the other end of this.
A packed house showed up at the Jepson Center recently to see Berendt in a rare public appearance.
My first introduction to Savannah was through the movie Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil. And now I live here.
We read the book, we saw the movie, now we can see the author.
As much as the city is a character in the book, so too is Berendt, a visitor to Savannah discovering her intriguing charms. Barron says that the key element of his writing style was access to the workings of his players.
I sort of push myself to push myself onto people. And if you do it tactfully enough, politely enough, people will say finally, yeah, okay, sure, I'll talk. So it's a big effort to get inside. I had to do this in Venice, Italy, too, where it's doubly difficult because I had to master Italian and get inside and talk to people. But if a tourist goes to Savannah, they won't see the inside lives that I was able to get to unless they somehow get into people's homes. The same is true in Venice. You go take a vaporetto down the Grand Canal, and you can see the wonderful palaces, but you won't get inside unless you somehow arrange to do so. I take you inside. And they would say to me, why don't you come this afternoon. Come for drinks. Come before. We can start drinking earlier. So very often, by the time I was finished talking to somebody in their living room, they had several drinks. That's their doing. I didn't force anybody to drink. But this would happen on occasion.
Barron's relationship with some of his characters is friendly, born of mutual admiration. But he is not friendly with everybody. Or rather, they're not friendly with him.
When's the last time you were in Mercer House?
I am not welcome in Mercer House. I'm not.
But his most lavish praise is reserved for the central figure in the book that made him rich.
I have to say, he was living at home the whole time I was here because he had been in jail for 2 years, then was released, and while I was researching my book and writing it, he was in Mercer House, and available to me, and he was hilariously funny, very articulate, very bright, a fascinating person. So I would call on him many times, and he helped me with information about lots of stuff I was interested in here. So that was, he was part of the atmosphere as well.
How lovely to see you out of bed.
Oh, Jim, I'd get out of bed for you anytime.
Less fascinating is his opinion of the movie made from his book, directed by Clint Eastwood with a star-studded cast who he thinks got it wrong.
You're leaving tonight.
In the new Midnight app, there are actual audio recordings that Barron contrasts with Kevin Spacey's characterization.
You got any money left over?
On my last 20.
You can hear both voices. And you hear the real Jim Williams' voice for once, not Kevin Spacey's very skewed and off-center version of it. And you hear Danny Hansford.
Part of the reason for his disdain is an author's pride and need for control. From the beginning, Barron insisted on being the sole person shaping the images created by Midnight.
The photos here might be the first time people have seen them.
I didn't want photographs with the book. I didn't want to compete with photographs because photographs are... It's a moment frozen in time, and that moment might be the wrong moment. I mean, if it's a tragic character, you have a picture of somebody laughing. This is the tragic character. But with my words, I can portray the person. I can create a portrait that evolves through the story. Happy, sad, excited, or dead, or whatever. So it's much more to the point to have a verbal, a prose description that proceeds along the lines of the book and the plot and the atmosphere. As a snapshot can't do it.
Tonight, in this Rose City, we are announcing nothing short of the future of books.
When we come back, we'll take you to the premiere party for the new Meta book, a trendy evening with some of Savannah's most celebrated figures.
In a world that runs at the speed of information, when it comes to news, you don't need your time wasted. That's why you can turn to WTOC 11 News to bring you news live as it happens, to focus on local stories and how they impact you where you live, to get you the news you need now, no matter where you are. For the stories that stay with you, there's only WTOC 11 News, live, local, now.
Got hurt.
hurt in a car wreck, and now I'm swimming in medical bills, and I don't know how I'm going to pay.
Do something about it. Just pick up the phone and call me.
I got hurt bad in a car wreck. The insurance guy keeps trying to get me to take a small offer.
Do something about your car wreck and call me.
I did something about it. I called Ken. He got me $125,000.
Ken got me $300,000.
Now, I can't guarantee you this kind of money, but if you've been hurt in a car wreck, do something about it. One call, that's all.
When you volunteer, you get more than you give.
Families who volunteer together often get more than they give. I'm teaching my children the importance of doing for others. It's just one lesson that volunteering as a family can provide. And when kids see their parents volunteering, it can change the way they see the world.
Volunteer with your family. You'll get more than you think. Call the United Way of the Coastal Empire to find out about volunteer opportunities in your community or visit us at uwce.org.
Everybody talks, everybody talks. It started with the whisper.
People just can't stop talking about Ford. And now during the Ford Summer Sales Event, get the best deals of the summer on Fusion with EcoBoost.
The Fusion is amazing.
Ford is the brand more people buy and buy again. So don't miss the Ford Summer Sales Event. Now during the Summer Sales Event, get a Fusion with 0 for 72, plus $1,000 and no payments for 90 days. Only at your local Ford dealer.
In early March, the Midnight Metabook team brought their show to Savannah to debut what is being called the future of books. The Metabook, an iPhone app, includes the book itself, a dramatic reading, audio recordings including conversations between Jim Williams and Danny Hansford, and photos galore.
Jim tells me in one of the tapes about how he prepares for his Christmas parties. In another tape, he tells about how he prepared, how he met Jacqueline Onassis in his house. And those went right into the book. I might have edited what he said so that it fits on a page, but it's word for word. You might recognize some of the words that he tells me.
The app is a work in progress. It can be updated with new information, including a notice that no one at the Jepson Center wanted to hear.
So when there's a musical, you may wake up one day and find that there's a song on your Midnight in the Garden of Good and Evil app. And eventually, I have to say it, I hope they'll include it, and I hope they'll treat me well, but eventually my obituary will be on it as well. Thank you. We'll end on a fun note, and that's it.
A little dark humor is to be expected from a man who immortalized many of the quirks and color of Savannah and brought millions of tourists to our town. That is this edition of WTOC Prime. Stay tuned for Elementary. Good night.
In a world that runs at the speed of information.